muri studio za Ishuri TV. Ishuri TV ni YouTube channel ibagezaho amasomo agiye atandukanye iby'ikoranabuhanga electronics, basic electronics and advanced electronics. Twigisha kandi gastronomy, ibijyanye no guteka n'ibijyanye n'iryo yuzuye muri rusange. Music, instrument, uko bacuranga piano, gitari n'andi masomo agiye atandukanye tuzanye na tubagezaho. Mbere yo gukomeza mbabwira isomo turi bwigwe umunsi, baje kubasuhuza aho muri hose ku isi, abari mu Rwanda mu ntara zose ndetse n'umujyi wa Kigali, mugubwe neza. By'umwihariko ndasuhuza Jean Paul kuri kamera, ugubwe neza. Hanyuma uyu munsi turaza kwigana type of sensor yitwa passive infrared sensor. Iyi passive infrared sensor ni sensor ibasha kudetectinga cyangwa se kubona motion cyangwa se muvuma y'umuntu. Wayifashisha mu gufata ibisambo muri thief detector, tuzajya tubireba no muri pratique. Uyu munsi turiga theories yayo, uko ikora n'ibindi bigiye bitandukanye, ntimucikwe n'iri somo. Murakoze.
Like to greet you once again. This evening we are going to teach you the second type of a sensor, which is called PIR sensor or passive infrared sensor. A PIR sensor or passive infrared sensor is an electronic sensor that measures infrared light radiating from object in its field of view. They are most often used in PIR based motion detectors. PIR sensors are commonly used in security alarms and automatic lighting applications. PIR sensor detects general movement but does not give information on who or what moved. For that purpose, an active IR sensor is required. So in summary, you understand that the passive infrared sensor is mostly used to radiate infrared, while its radiation are being interfered by any obstacle. It reflects, or it the reflection of that infrared caused by that obstacle causes it to produce output. It can produce an alarm or making the output of writing according to the designer of the circuit. But simply you have to understand that the operation of passive infrared is to radiate the infrared and in its view or in its field of view, when there is obstacle presented in its field, then the reflection caused by those obstacle produce the output. It will back to the passive infrared sensor causing the output. Then PIR sensor are commonly called simply PIR or PID. PID means passive infrared detector. The terms passive refer to the fact that PIR device does not radiate energy from detection purpose. They work entirely by detecting infrared radiation, radiant heat emitted by deflected from the object. Most passive infrared sensors have 3-pin connection. At the side or button, one pin will be ground either would be the power, other would be the output. As you see in this image, it has there's the three pins. You see, one pin is ground, other is voltage or power supply, other is the output. Then output timing, there is a variable resistor which used for timing. This is output timing. This is sensitivity. There is also jumper, phone or set or auto reset. You have to fix it according to your desire. Then this infrared sensor is or has ability to be supplied by 20 from 5 up to 20 DC voltage. The output pin is the second. Then the third one is ground, you see on this image. So don't have direct output and instead just operate a relay switch, a relay which case there is a ground, power and two switch access association infra interfering the PI ALA with microcontroller is very easy and simple. The PI ALA act as digital output, so all you need to do is listening for the pin to flip high or low. You see, in few words, you have to understand that the PI ALA sensor is the one which used especially for security. It can be used for managing the security where you in a silent zone or in where you don't need any movement. When it is applied there, it radiates its infrared and the people or any object will passing through in the field view of the PI ALA motion will reflect the feedback and cause to produce output. Can be alarm, can be light, can be phone call, anything you want. We will show you how to use it in practice. Thank you for attending this lesson. It was to show you PI ALA sensor and how it can be applied, where it can be applied and how to install it. We will show you many in practice. Thank you for attending this lesson. We would like to remind you that it's better to like, share and subscribe on YouTube.